car, so let me tell you the foolishness. So, and you might want to speed this up because I'm so tired that I'm going to be talking slow. So, I'm warning you ahead of time.
So, last night, I don't know if I told you, I started interacting with one new guy and two leftover guys. You know, we were talking before Thanksgiving. They stopped talking to me, and now they're talking to me again. And both of them said that they didn't think I was interested because I'm nonchalant. I told you about the one who thought I might like girls because I'm cool as fuck. Okay. The one who stopped talking to me because he thought I was nonchalant. Me and him was supposed to go out yesterday. He completely blew me off. So I'm completely done with him. The one who thought that I might like girls, we're probably going to go out one day next week. But the one I was up all night talking to, I was up all night talking to him. Like, I text him about 8:30, good night. He texts me about 9 o'clock, I'm going to call you in a few minutes. About 9:30, 10 o'clock, he called. We ain't get off the phone till about 3:30. He kept trying to persuade me into telling him to come on down here and hang out with me today because he was off today. He was just the bus at 3:30. Get here about 4:40. And I told him I could take him to a hotel because he couldn't stay in my spot, you know. But if you really want to see me. But I was trying to talk him out of it because that'd be like $100 for the hotel. And then, you know, coming down here. And he probably would only be able to see me we'll have breakfast this morning, then I took him to the hotel, and then I would have had to do all this foolishness I got going with the car. So then, at about 2 o'clock, I was like, you know what, fuck it, you want to come, come, because you know that other dude, I had told, he was 6 hours away and wanted to drive, and I was like, I don't think you should, and then he stopped talking to me, but it wasn't that reason, he stopped talking to me because he didn't believe in God, and I do, and he ain't seen no way to persuade me, because there is no way to persuade me, I'm equally yoked and all of that, so I told him he was on some bullshit because he ran the clock out about 3:15. That's when he started talking about packing and shit. And he was like, well, check that. Let's see if the bus running late, then I'll be coming. That motherfucking bus on the bus tracker, it was going to be there at 3:30. It was going to be gone at 3:35. There ain't no way he was going to make it in time. So, we all got the Cash App. He has the Cash App. He's like, well, shit, I can just put money on the Cash App and you come here because it's a bus leaving Mobile to come here. Nah, bruh. That wasn't the plan. Okay, so I get up this morning. I got about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours sleep. I got up this morning. And I started calling around trying to get me a tow company. Go ahead and tow my shit to the shop. My mom's shit to the shop. Them bosses was like anywhere from $150 to $180. I wasn't willing to spend that kind of loot. So I called my brother. I'm like, come on, we got to pull mama car. I mean, we got to get it done. I said, we can pull. It was like 5 something in the morning. The place don't open there. I said, you come now. And we pull it now. I said, I'll just sit there. I'll eat that time. I got tablets and movies and shit. It don't matter to me. We tried to pull her car. The little old jinky ropey cat broke 3 times. So we figured out you can't pull it. It was foggy than a motherfucker. Oh, he got behind mama car in my truck. I was in the passenger side. And we pushed her car over 14 miles to the place. That was a lot of pushing. Royce was stirring her car. And Kenny was pushing mine. But we got it there. And my brother drives so bad. He ain't never, ever, 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 ever driving another vehicle that belongs to me. I kept telling him, I was like, Roy, Kenny, B got issues. You can't just drive her like that. Oh, she just needs, she got issues. Her issue is she need to be drove. I'm like, Kenny, I need this car I need this car, period, because I want this to be precious get about car. But I definitely need it until I get my truck this year coming up. Oh, ain't nothing wrong with this car. So then he started hearing it where it don't want to switch out. Because I'm not trying to speak deaf on my truck, but it got issues. I'm just going to keep saying it like that. It's not going to die no time soon. And before the issues turn into anything serious, I'm going to be able to get the issues dealt with. But it got issues. And then he was throwing it and shifting it all bad and shit. But he was doing a favor for me, E.I. Mom. So I was trying not to go out. But he will never, Lord willing, drive anything else that belongs to me. If I need him to do something, he gonna have to be in the passenger seat and I'm gonna be driving, and he'll just have to talk me through making sure I do the shit right. Okay, so we left Royce with the car to take Kenny's wife to work and stuff and came back because she had to be at work at the same time the place opened, blah, blah, blah. We get back there, my car is sitting there. I had already called them people at the shop. Yeah, you know, because I wanted to get it done yesterday. And they were like, it probably won't be done in one day. You get here before we open, or as we open, then it'll be done. So I get there, and they're working on two other cars. And I'm like, what the fuck, right? So I go up in there. I'm like, dude, you said. And then I was like, well, I don't know if it was you. It was him. Yeah. But I said, you said that if I got it here at the start of day, it would be ready before y'all close shop down. Well, I can't guarantee. I said, that's what you said, though. Because I was going to bring it yesterday, but you said. That's what you said, though. I got out my bed before day and got the car here. Because my mom needs her shit. That's what you said. And he said, well, we got this car, and this car was here from yesterday, so we have to finish this car. And then we're going to put your car in the thing. But I'm short mechanics. He said, but we get to your car and we store it on your car. We will not stop until your car is finished. I said, don't say if. I'm number three. Y'all gonna get, I don't care how short mechanics y'all are. Y'all gonna get to my car. So 2 weeks ago, he had quoted me $530. To God be the glory, he just called me today and said $484 and some change out the door, tax included. Y'all can't tell me. That nigga who say ain't no God, that he his own God, the law of attraction book, bitch, bye, miss me with that. My God is good. I was praying. I prayed the whole way there with us pushing Mama Cock. I was freaking out. I was like, Lord, please give us traveling grace. What he do? He gave us traveling grace. I said, Lord, please let it be that or less. Let them figure out how to make this thing work out. Well, it's less than what they quoted me a couple of weeks ago. And what happened? It's less. All these fools walking around talking about some ain't no God. That's exactly what they are. Fools and jackasses. Oh. I'm waiting on him to call me and let me know that the car is ready. I was hoping and praying that he would be done by 2. But seeing as it's almost 2 now, more than likely I'm going to have to find somebody to go with me to drive. Because I don't want Kenny driving any of vehicles that are attached to me ever again. It don't make no sense to drive that bad. We wasn't in no hurry. Didn't have nowhere we had to be. It's a lazy, breezy, cool, chilling ass Thursday day. Neither one of us had to be at work or anything. And he was just driving my shit like, it's okay. So, that was it. But yes, I reached my goal. Mom will have her car before I leave to go out of town.
Frank's still trying to recover from Hurricane Maria. 35% of the island is now heading into Christmas with still no power. You'll remember that the hurricane hit back in September.
Whatever you
Today, the Army Corps said that there are some towns in Puerto Rico that they don't expect to get any power to at all.
Power. Help us to walk in it, oh God.
Wow.
You're giving us that power.
Somebody must have been turning too fast.
The enemy. And nothing shall by enemy
yep.
hurt us.
Turning too fast.
In the name of Jesus.
I hope nobody got hurt.
Complete.
Yep. Don't trip. This is what it is.
Yeah, we're out in our pajamas. But we had to come pay on the thing before the place closed.